May 2022 is upon us, which means we are gearing up for summer. But first, we take a look at what the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers has been up to over the past month. In this, our monthly vlog called Corps Connection. Welcome to another edition of Corps Connection. I'm your host, Patrick Bloodgood. This month, we look at a lock that has had all its water removed, how survey crews keep our waterways safe, birds are getting new habitat in Chesapeake Bay, and we preview National Dam Safety Awareness Month by going out to California to get a look at one dam that is going through a massive safety overhaul. Our first story takes us to the Wilson Lock. The lock is getting a detailed once-over as Nashville District crews drain the water and are getting an up-close look at the structure as part of scheduled maintenance.
Maintenance crews from U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Nashville District and the Great Lakes and Ohio River Division Regional Rivers Repair Fleet began to dewater the main chamber of Wilson Lock in Florence, Alabama, March 23rd of 2022. The dewatering allows maintenance crews to inspect the chamber and conduct maintenance in dry conditions, ensuring the lock continues to provide safe passage for more than 2,500 government, commercial, and recreational vessels moving up and down the Tennessee River. The process of dewatering begins long before a single gallon of water is pumped out of the chamber. While the ideal schedule for dewatering is every 3 to 5 years, the planning process can begin 2 to 3 years in advance, ultimately prolonging the schedule.
We started developing a strategy, repair strategy for the gate, and also looked at other components that need to be repaired at the same time.
Once the chamber is empty, maintenance crews can make repairs to the miter gates, inspect the filling and emptying valves, and the rest of the components of the main chamber. While dewatering provides an opportunity for maintenance and engineer crews to inspect the lock during dry conditions, it also provides engineers with historical records of previous inspection findings for a comparison.
This process, all I'm doing is inspecting documentation every day with pictures and reports of what's going on with the lock and our problems with it. So in the end, we can have historical record and a review when we do other gates and this gate again on what has been done and what will need to be done.
The dewatering inspection will conclude on April 28th, 2022 and provide the Nashville District and Great Lakes and Ohio River Division insight on maintenance and repairs required in the future. This is Heather King reporting for the Nashville District at Wilson Lock.
Across the nation, USACE districts employ survey teams to make sure our nation's navigation channels are at their prescribed depths and clear of underwater obstructions. As our Charleston District explains, it's a vital mission to keep commerce, recreational, and military vessels moving.
Army Corps of Engineers Charleston District is responsible for over 300 miles of federal channels in South Carolina. And our waterway reaches all the way from Port Royal near Georgia all the way up to Little River in North Carolina. It is our responsibility to maintain depths along that waterway for commercial and recreational purposes. We also have ports that we deal with, Charleston being the top priority, and then Georgetown and Port Royal. In the survey section, we have multiple capabilities. We have multi-beam sonar, which we can do 100% coverage maps of the seafloor, and we also use single beam. The single beam allows us to determine the condition of the channels. So using the single beam for condition work allows us to pinpoint problem areas. And then at that point, we can take more of our specific equipment, like our multi-beam or side scan sonars, to look at direct things that may be in the channel that need to be removed. So when we are out there and we're determining what the depths are, all of that information is shared with our partner agencies, and that is Port of Charleston, the Coast Guard, Navy, Army. Everybody here depends on those depths, so it is our responsibility to make sure they are maintained.
Our Norfolk District has gone to the birds. Actually, they are working to create bird habitat in the lower Chesapeake Bay to help offset a loss in nesting grounds due to tunnel expansion in the area. And since we celebrated Earth Day last month, what better way to highlight what USACE is doing for the environment than having the district explain how they are using dredged material to create new habitat for threatened and endangered species.
We're dedicated to protecting the nation's delicate ecosystems while allowing reasonable and necessary development. That's why the Norfolk District U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is rallying around Virginia's largest and most productive seabird colony. The Hampton Roads Bird Habitat Restoration Project will create and restore primary habitat for bird species displaced due to the Hampton Roads Bridge Tunnel expansion. Construction will include using dredged material from the Norfolk Harbor and Channels Navigation Improvement Project. Aims for the project include restoring approximately 10 to 12 acres of nesting habitat while demonstrating sustainable nesting and fledgling success for multiple relocated species. This unique, large, multi-species colony of approximately 25,000 individuals is the only one of its kind on the western shore of the Chesapeake Bay. With help from the Virginia Department of Wildlife Resources, this project will restore a safe, permanent, and biologically appropriate habitat for the colony. Provide habitat for shorebirds, wading birds, and migratory birds throughout the year. Reduce bird strike by both adjacent vehicles on the nearby interstate highway and aircrafts of Naval Station Norfolk's Chambers Field, thereby increasing safety in Norfolk Harbor. Ecologically and economically advance important fishery resources and benthic species. Beneficially use the dredged material from local construction and maintenance projects. This 100% federally funded project is sanctioned under Section 204 of the Water Resources Development Act of 1992. Authorizing the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to implement projects for the protection, restoration, and creation of aquatic and ecologically related habitats in connection with dredging for the construction or operations and maintenance of an existing authorized federal navigation project.
May 31st is National Dam Safety Awareness Day, and in honor of that day, we take you to California, where the Sacramento District is actively making the Isabella Dam safer through a multi-million dollar, multi-year project.
The size and scope of U.S. Army engineering projects is astounding. A new spillway excavated from the hillside and deep into the rock, sometimes more than 100 feet deep, and supported by hundreds of anchor bolts that extend up to 35 feet into the rock. A concrete weir with three-story tall walls that rise up to meet the horizon. An on-site rock materials processing plant where we make dam embankment materials such as filter, sand, and drain rock. An on-site concrete batch plant where we mix and prepare the concrete needed to build this colossal structure. And a team of up to 300 construction workers at a time, often working two shifts per day to complete the project. Let's explore some of the big features of the Isabella Dam Safety Modification Project. The project's Phase 2 dams and spillways construction began in January 2018 and addresses a series of identified dam safety issues while bringing the dams and spillways up to modern design criteria. Identification of an active fault, potential flood overtopping, and seepage issues put the Isabella Lake project at unacceptably high risk. Even with only a remote possibility of one of the dams failing, not only would public safety hazards be potentially catastrophic for the downstream communities of Lake Isabella, the Kern River Valley, and Bakersfield, but the economic impacts would be felt across the nation. So the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers designed some big engineering solutions to address some big challenges. One of the main project features and a visibly unique upgrade is the new labyrinth weir and emergency spillway. The sawtooth-shaped structure was designed by USACE engineers and physically modeled at Utah State University's engineering department to ensure the largest flood events could be safely passed through the spillways. Water flows over a 28-foot-tall concrete weir that is placed in a nearly 1,200-foot-long footprint along the upstream arc. But if straightened out, the sawtooth structure would stretch more than 3,000 feet long. From there, water continues down a 1,500-foot-long rock spillway and into the Kern River downstream. Isabella Lake's main and auxiliary dams are each being raised 16 feet from their current crest elevations to accommodate higher reservoir levels during rare storm events. And the existing service spillway walls are being raised and modified to also safely route higher flows during those rare storm events. Isabella Lake and the surrounding Sequoia National Forest are a popular destination for outdoor recreation and natural beauty, and the surrounding region is a hub for agricultural goods that feed the nation. The Corps of Engineers' primary purpose with the Isabella Dam Safety Modification Project continues to be the improvement of public safety without altering the structure's original long-term benefits. The project is scheduled to be complete in 2022. A marvel of engineering innovation.
That finishes off this month's edition of Core Connection. Remember, the Atlantic hurricane season begins on June 1st, and in our next month's episode, we will be covering how USACE has been preparing for what may be an active season. Until then, I'm Patrick Bloodgood, and this has been Core Connection.